What's up, YouTube? You're watching Jay's Two Cents, and this week I've been asked a million times about how much RAM you really need on your graphics card. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about in this episode of A Little Bite of Tech. It's no joke, people. I think a lot of people are really confused about how much RAM they really need on their video card. What I'm doing here is I'm running Haven Benchmark. This is a synthetic benchmark where it runs a bunch of loops and it turns on tessellation and DirectX 11 and such. And if we look at MSI Afterburner here, you can see we're only using 800 megabytes at 1080p resolution. The most we've ever used in this benchmark here was 817 megabytes, as you can see right there in the red font. So I went ahead and let this run a few times, just to see how much we could absolutely max out the memory usage. Settings were put as high as they would possibly go. And you can see again, we're sitting right about the 800 megabyte mark. That is nowhere near the 2 gigabytes that this GTX 680 has. And I went ahead and ran the 3D Mark 11 benchmark, and it was even less. I didn't even bother putting up a picture of it here because it only used 350 megabytes. But a lot of people will say, hey, that's not fair. This is a synthetic benchmark, so we went ahead and loaded up Battlefield 3. And we, as you can see here, all settings are on Ultra, 4x, MSAA, and look at that. We are sitting once again about 961 megabytes of video RAM used. You can see, however, though, that the usage is going up and down as high as 1.1 gigabytes of video RAM. So what I'm showing you here is what's affecting that is the MSAA. And as I go through the different settings, you can see that the amount of memory used on the left goes up and down depending on that setting. Same thing with ambient occlusion, which is the type of lighting effects that are used inside the app. So right off the bat, you can see here at max settings, everything put as high as you can go, an anisotropic filter had no effect on the memory usage whatsoever. At 1080p on max settings on Battlefield 3, which is one of the more demanding games that are out on the market, we never used more than 1100 megabytes of memory. So I went ahead and ran out into the game. This is a 64-player map, and I never used more than 1,462 megabytes of RAM. So I went ahead and then next took the most demanding game that people can consider right now, which is the Crysis 3 beta, and I was a little surprised here. I was using a lot less RAM than I thought. Never used more than 1,200 megabytes. All right, kids, so what did we learn with today's Bite of Tech? Well, right off the bat, if you're using a single monitor for gaming and you're not doing any sort of a triple monitor setup, 2 gigabytes is more than enough. You can have as much as 500 megabytes of your video RAM left over even while gaming at max settings at 1080p. However, if you are going to be using something that's higher than 1080p, 1200p, 1440, or even 1600 on like a Dell UltraSharp, you're going to definitely want the higher amount of RAM, the 4 gigabytes or even the 6 gigabytes offered on some AMD cards, because the MSAA at higher resolutions is what's using that amount of RAM. Same thing if you're going to be gaming with more than one monitor, you're going to definitely want the higher amount of VRAM. But then again, at that, if you're going to be using more than one monitor for gaming, I definitely recommend more than one video card as well. So that's it for this first installment of A Little Bite of Tech. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.